Hi everyone, the Lone Wolf here. Welcome back to a quick EVE Online video. In today's video, I want to talk a little bit about the latest dev blog that was released by CCP, and it's all about the new mining ledgers that are coming to the game with the expansion EVE Online Lifeblood that should be coming next week. So let's head over to the dev blog in question, introducing the mining ledger, new tools for miners in EVE Online. It's more spreadsheets in space, but I think for miners, this can actually be a pretty nice tool to give yourself a little bit of an idea of what your mining activity is actually doing. And especially if you look at the window right here, as it is presented in the dev blog, you have the column estimated price, which I think will be very helpful if that works well and keeps everything up to date quite nicely. You'll just be able to select the different types of ores that you mine, and with the volumes and the estimated price, you'll be able to know which ones you should prioritize, because they've been doing the best for like probably the last 3 months or so. I think that was the range of the time frame that CCP is aiming at for the personal mining ledger. So I'm seeing two big advantages here. First of all, as I've already explained, I think that this will help especially newer players to decide which ores they should prioritize, because they can very easily from the mining ledger determine over the last mining sessions which ores have made them the most ISK at the estimated price. Of course, it's never gonna be an exact science when it comes to estimated price, but it should give you a bit of an idea of which ones to go for first. And another one, I'm seeing this as a little bit of a hook for newer players that do enjoy the mining activity in EVE Online. I fully understand that it's not for everyone, but I myself really enjoy mining. I do most of that in an Orca from belts that are near my own structures, so I don't really mind that much if I'm mining less effectively, if I mine just some straight up feldspar or stuff like that. I try to empty out the belt a little bit as I go along, but for newer players to have this tool, to have this spreadsheet basically that shows them the progress of everything that they've mined over the last few days, but also over a longer period of time of several months, I think it could work as a bit of a hook to help them stay motivated, to see what they've been doing, maybe to watch their efficiency increase as they go from a venture to maybe a mining barge and eventually to the Orca. All of that I think is some pretty good stuff when it comes to the personal mining ledger. More information is always better. The big one, of course, is the corporate mining ledger. That one is a little bit different because it is going to be tied to the new moon mining mechanic, at first only for Nullsec and Lowsec space, but we know that CCP has announced that moon mining is also coming to Wormhole space and 0.5 systems in Highsec. So looks like a pretty cool way to stay informed about what has been mined by which party. This will go down to the very individual. You've got corporation, the pilot itself, then the ore type, the quantity, and then an estimated price category again. This should help larger groups basically with their bookkeeping a little bit. Maybe they can find thieves when some of those show up, and maybe they can like tax the right corporations at the right prices for the rights that they're then trying to sell, I guess, to get in on their moon mining activities. For me personally, I'm seeing the exact opposite. What I can do is I can try to get a moon mining setup going in Dital, which is going to be my next goal after the expansion. And then rather than try to tax people for the stuff that they mine from my moon, I can do the exact opposite. I can, for instance, try to give out prizes for the top three miners that have the most estimated value or maybe the most quantity, and as a result I can maybe try to attract more customers to do some mining for me. That should then translate to more stuff inside my structures and those more business inside my structures as well. So I think that this can work both ways for big Nullsec groups that want to sell the moon mining activities to some other groups. They can use this to tax those guys, and for other people that basically need to attract more people to make the most out of their moon mining setups, well, you can do the exact opposite. You can reward people that show the most interest in that. A big one that's actually all all the way at the bottom here is that all of this will be in APIs and will be exportable, which is of course very nice. Just like CCP, I'm also eagerly awaiting what kind of tools people will create when it comes to this information from the two mining ledgers. And maybe I rarely do anything outside of the game, but maybe a cool app that that handles and that shows some nice market related stuff when it comes to the mining ledgers. I think that could be very cool. And so yeah, lots of potential, lots of fresh information that is gonna come to EVE Online with the mining ledgers. And I look forward to all of that. Thank you very much for watching, guys. I'll see you all next time.